Dear friends, whenever we all walk into stores, malls today, we see parallel black lining strips and all kind of tags attached to everything. And let's see a video to know how it's working. You take anything and it's possible to give you a bill when you walk out of the store. You must have understood that it's radio frequency identification, RFID technology at work. There are so many types of such tags that we all see attached to everything. Some of them you can see in this picture. Here you can see all types of RFID tags embedded in different products. Some of these are washable and some of them can be discarded. Technology has changed and is continuously changing all the sectors. Retail is not different than that. Today we will try to see the use of barcode and radio frequency identification, that is RFID technology, in retailing. We will see today what is barcode and RFID and why, how it is used in retailing and businesses, and how the businesses are getting benefited from these technologies. Let's first see what is a barcode and how it is used in businesses. A barcode is an optical machine readable representation of data relating to the object to which it is attached. Barcodes are used to represent data by changing widths and spacing of parallel lines. They are referred to as linear or one-dimensional. After some time, they were designed into rectangles, dots, hexagons, and other geometric patterns in two dimensions. Many types of these symbols are used in 2D systems. They are generally referred to as barcodes. Barcodes originally were scanned by special optical scanners called barcode readers. Later, scanners and interpretive software became available on devices including desktop printers and smartphones. When they were used to automate supermarket checkout systems, barcodes became commercially successful. Their use has spread to many other tasks that are generically referred to as automatic identification and data capture. The very first scanning of the now ubiquitous universal product code, that is UPC, barcode was on a pack of Ringlet company chewing gum in June 1974. Barcodes such as the UPC have become a ubiquitous element of modern civilization. They were adopted by stores around the world. Most items other than fresh produce from a grocery store now have UPC barcodes. They were used in tracking items and to reduce instances of shoplifting involving price tag swapping. Of course, shoplifters can now print their own barcodes. Retail chain membership cards, which are issued mostly by grocery stores and specially big boss retail stores such as sporting equipments, office supply, or pet stores, use barcodes to uniquely identify customers. This allows customized marketing and greater understanding of individual consumer shopping patterns. They are widely used in the healthcare and hospital settings for patient identification, that is to assess patient data, including medical history, drug allergies, etc. In point of sale management, barcode systems can provide detailed up-to-date information on the business. This also helps in accelerating decisions and with more confidence. For example, fast selling items can be identified quickly and automatically reordered. Slow selling items can be identified, preventing inventory buildup. The effects of merchandising changes can be monitored, allowing fast moving, more profitable items to occupy the best space. Historical data can be used to predict seasonal fluctuations very accurately. Items may be repriced on the shelf to reflect both sales prices and price increases. This technology also enables the profiling of individual consumers, typically through a voluntary registration of discount cards. While pitched as a benefit to the customer, this practice is considered to be potentially dangerous by privacy advocates. Besides sales and inventory tracking, barcodes are very useful in logistics and supply chain management. When a manufacturer packs a box for shipment, a unique identification number can be assigned to the box. A database can link the UID to relevant information about the box, such as order number, items packed, quantity packed, destinations, etc. The information can be transmitted through a communication system such as electronic data interchange. So, the retailer has the information about a shipment before it arrives. Shipments that are sent to a distribution center are tracked before forwarding. When the shipment reaches its final destination, the UID gets scanned, so the store knows the shipment's source, contents, and cost. Today, barcodes are commonly used as an affordable way to help making business operations more efficient. Now, let's look at the radio frequency identification technology and its use. This is the extension of the effort to make business operations more efficient by eliminating the lacunas of the barcodes. Today, the retail industry is facing a serious challenge due to rapidly changing market conditions, fueled by increasing global competition, higher performance expectations by customers and the market, and ever-evolving technologies. During the past 3 decades, the industry has grown significantly due to technological innovations and by adopting supply chain management techniques, such as QR, that is quick response, which combine technologies, modular layouts, process re-engineering, total quality management, and employee. While quick response or QR has been a successful initiative for the retail industry, there is a growing need for a new technology to sustain and revive its vitality in order to deal with the increasing market pressure and customer demand. The industry welcomes RFID as a possible solution to this challenge. Although it is not clear what the limits of the technology and how it harnesses it to maximize its benefit while controlling its risks. Accordingly, there is a demand for a comprehensive framework of RFID that can be used as a roadmap for researchers as well as practitioners. RFID provides a way for organizations to identify and manage tools and equipments, that is asset tracking, without manual data entry. RFID is being adopted for item level tagging in retail stores. This provides electronic article surveillance and a self-checkout process for consumers. Automatic identification with RFID can be used for inventory systems. By far, the greatest interest in RFID technology revolves around the task of tracking individual products or items to improve inventory and supply chain management. While mobile RFID devices are already in the market, the infrastructure is also beginning to grow for RFID payments, such as several retailers from McDonald's to Starbucks in the UK have already signed up. In today's world, with heavily growing demand in the retail industry, there is an urge for material availability, service, and increasing competition. Due to increased speed in goods flow, greater levels of automation, and ever decreasing price and size of tags, the importance and relevance of RFID technology in worldwide logistics is substantial. Actually, this is the functionality of RFID that destined it to replace barcode soon. Also, the global competition between the retail stores have forced the stores to rethink how they should provide the appropriate service to the customers to sustain their place in the market. Radio frequency identification technology has numerous potential applications and accompanying technologies, and it depicts a subsequent incremental stage shift towards improvements in retail business. Number of authors agreed that RFID has a bright future in the retail industry as a replacement of barcode. Projects executed by the Walmart, Gillette, Tesco, and Procter & Gamble, etc., shows admirable results and researches compared to current scenarios led us to believe that RFID implementation will drive us towards great changes in future. From a consumer perspective, RFID is a fairly simple approach. However, for a retailer, this technology has massive implications on the supply chain. The cost benefit analysis of implementing tags on all products to have real time asset management, warehouse management, and supply chain visibility is immensely valuable. Each product now can be accurately tracked from its raw material straight through the manufacturing process and finally to the individual end user. RFID is compared mostly with the barcodes because they both can be used in similar ways and in many similar areas. Though RFID is a more advanced technology, an example of the differences is that an RFID reader can identify a large number of objects around the same time, while barcodes can only be identified one by one. A barcode must be placed visible just in front of the reader to be read, while an RFID tagging or tag can be read at long distances away through most materials and for a higher speed and precision. The disadvantages are that there are many different standards. Implementation of an RFID system is complex and it is more expensive in the current situation. In this table, you can see this comparison. We can see here that RFID can process large amount of data while barcodes can be processed one at a time. As far as readability is concerned, RFID can be read many at once and from long distance even if they are dirty and made by various materials. Barcodes can read one at a time and they must be visible, clean and undamaged. Of course, as the RFID technology is evolving and is more complicated in implementation, while barcodes are really easy. Cost is high for RFID today and barcodes are very cheap compared to RFID, which can be printed in the house also. As far as security is concerned, RFID is more secure than barcodes. RFID is growing and is in demand. As per the Statistica, the graph shows the RFID global market. You can see the tremendous growth of this technology in all sectors of the businesses. ID TechX find that in 2014, the total RFID market was worth $8.89 billion, up to from $7.77 billion in 2013 and $6.96 billion in 2012. This includes tags, readers and software services for RFID cards, labels, fobs and all other form factors. ID TechX forecast that to rise to $27.31 billion in 2024. In retail, RFID is seeing rapid growth for apparel tagging. That application alone was demanding 3 billion RFID labels in 2014 and 7% of the total addressable market for apparel was in 2014. RFID in the form of tickets used for transit had demanded 700 million tags in 2014. The tagging of animals such as pigs, sheep, pets is now substantial as it becomes a legal requirement in many territories. With 425 million tags were used in 2014, this is happening in regions such as China and Australia. In total, 6.9 billion tags were sold versus 5.8 billion in 2013. Most of that growth is from passive UHF RFID labels, which UHF tag sales overtaking HF and LF tag sales by volume was in 2012. However, in 2013, UHF tag sales by value was only by 11% of the value of HF tag sales. Now, let us look at the Indian scenario of retail and RFID technology. Demand for supply chain management, organized retail market growth and government projects are the major growth factors of RFID technology and industry in India. RFID is an automatic identification process, as we all know. It provides a unique identification to the objects. The rapidly increasing industrialization and commercialization is tempting the companies to invest in RFID to enhance their supply chain processes, as it enables scanning of multiple atoms at once and line of sight advantage. The major factors driving the market for RFID include increased usage in the large scale government projects such as Aadhaar, Unique Identification Program, Metro Rail and retail industry in India. According to recently published report by TechSci, Research India RFID market forecast and opportunities 2018, the RFID market in India is expected to grow at the CAGR of around 25% during 2013 to 2018. The usage of RFID technology is rapidly increasing across the country, and it is growing extensively in the regions where industrial and manufacturing developments are more prominent. Maharashtra and Gujarat in western region, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu in southern region are the markets accounting for high usage of RFID in India. The main companies operating in the Indian RFID market includes Infotech Software and Systems, Gantech, Motorola Solutions and NEC Corporation. Mr. Karan Chechi, who is research director with TechSci Research, which is a research based global management consulting firm, says the growth of organized retail, automotive, healthcare and public transit are expected to contribute significantly to the demand for RFID in India. In addition, the RFID technology is also expected to be deployed in new emerging applications such as animal tracking, libraries and precious ornaments, etc. The growth of companies operating in these sectors, along with the foray of multinational companies in the market, would add to the growth of RFID in India. The report from TechSci also identifies and analyzes the emerging trends along with the essential drivers, challenges and opportunities available in RFID market in India. Now, let us see what this RFID is. RFID is the wireless use of electromagnetic fields to transfer data for the purpose of automatically identifying and tracking tags attached to an object. The tags contain electronically stored information. Some tags are powered by electromagnetic induction from magnetic fields produced near the reader. Some act as passive transponder. Other types have a battery and may operate at hundreds of meters from the reader. Unlike a barcode, the tag does not necessarily need to be within the line of sight of the reader and may be embedded in the tracking object. RFID is one method for automatic identification and data capture. RFID tags are used in many industries. For example, an RFID tag attached to an automobile during production can be used to track its progress through the assembly line. RFID tagged pharmaceuticals can be tracked through warehouses, and implementing RFID microchips in the livestock and pets allows positive identification of animals. It consists of a tiny silicon computer chip and an antenna. Remote reader can scan and send to a database. Today, it is also considered as a backbone of Internet of Things. Now, let us see the components of RFID. An RFID system consists of three major components. An RFID tag, known as transponder, which is composed of a microchip with a content antenna and in some cases a battery, which are enclosed within plastic, silicon or sometimes glass. Second is an RFID reader containing a radio transceiver, which receive and interpret the information transmitted by the antenna. And the third one is a host computer that manages the tags and the readers. And then the integration is done for business applications. There are different types of tags which are available today, but major three kind of RFID tags are passive, semi-active and active. Passive tags have no energy source of their own. Semi-active tags have a power source for the chip, but not for transmission. and active tags have their own power source for the chip and the transmission. Essentially, they all work the same way. Although they differ in the amount of data they can store and the range at which they can be read. Among the three types, passive RFID tags are by far the most widely used. Passive tags are manufactured to be disposable, just like the consumer products on which they are often placed. One way to characterize a passive RFID tag is a barcode label on steroids. A passive RFID tag contains 3 times the amount of information as a barcode label, maybe up to 96 bits. Additionally, RFID readers do not require line of sight contact like a barcode scanner. Passive RFID tags can be read through cardboard, wood, and plastic at a range up to 30 feet. Now, let's see how it works. Step 1 is data within an RFID tag's microchip waits to be read. Next, the tag's antenna receives wireless RF signals, electromagnetic energy from an RFID reader's antenna with a message, example request for information generated via the host computer. Step 3, using power from its internal battery or power harvested from the reader's electromagnetic field, the tag sends a radio wave message back to the reader. In the next step, the reader picks up the tag's radio waves and interprets the frequencies as meaningful data. Step 5 is the reader then passes the information wirelessly or through a docking station to the host computer for processing and interpretation. An intelligent program that uses business rules does the interpretation. Now, let's see where it can be used. It can be used for access management, tracking of goods, tracking of persons and animals, toll collection and contactless payments, machine readable travel documents, smart dust, which is also known as massively distributed sensor networks, tracking sports, airport baggage tracking logistics, timing sporting events, etc. Formed in November 2010 by a group of US retailers, apparel suppliers, industry associations and academicians, and RFID solution providers, the item level RFID initiative was introduced, and it aims to foster RFID's adoption in retail supply chain. The group launched item level RFID guidelines and item level RFID initiative that could be a game changer. For example, a pilot at 2 stores of Jones Apparel in New York City resulted in an 18% reduction in the time staff spent searching for products. In addition, the pilot showed a 25% of reduction in the amount of time that workers spent receiving goods at the store, a 92% decrease in the time required to perform cycle counts in the store, and an improvement in inventory accuracy from 85% to 90%. Up to 97% to 99%. Some of the benefits of RFID in retails are it empowers retailers to increase inventory visibility. It reduces labor costs and improve profitability by delivering the benefits of enterprise mobility to a variety of applications. It can automatically read and write RFID tags at shipping and receiving doors to expedite loading and unloading processes, improve customer satisfaction by ensuring that products are stocked and available, reduce shrinkage, fraud and spoilage, increase in stock merchandise for higher sales volumes and increase profits. It can reduce human intervention and decrease labor costs. It dramatically improves overall warehousing efficiencies. With RFID, retailer can have real-time inventory information that can help to prevent stockouts, locate stock within a store to avoid shrinkage of inventories, and it can help to enable retailer to use more yield-effective pricing strategies. RFID technology provides practical elimination of the need of human checking of stock. Labor reductions will be realized in the areas of retail operations. Receiving, stocking, checkout, cycle counting, and physical counting. In retail industry, shrinkage is a term used to describe inaccurate inventory counts, such as a result of customer theft, employee theft, inaccurate inventory counts due to misplaced items, and stock reordered because items are on a display shelf in other area of the store. RFID technology has the potential to alert staff when items are being removed illegally or when they have been misplaced within the stores. It can assist in theft reduction and also provide real-time accurate inventory counts automatically. Let's see supply chain management and RFID. Retailing is a set of business activities that adds value to the product and services sold by consumers for their personal and family use. However, retailing is not only consist of selling products and services in stores, but through many channels including internet, direct sales or advertisement sales. Retailers work as a link between the consumers and manufacturers of products and services. Competition increment and enhancement in the supply chain complexities are the nowadays problems for retailers. Everywhere in the world, business connectivity, global sourcing and advanced technologies are the new challenges for the retailers that are increasingly rapidly, and it's becoming mandatory for the retailers to manage their supply chain in a manner to stay competitive in the industry. RFID is really helping retailing industries to make the supply chain more and more efficient. Let's look at the case of Walmart. Walmart has grown to be the world's largest retailer by seeking every opportunity to streamline its supply chain and cut cost in order to live up to its promise of everyday low pricing. Getting there entails more than smart merchandising. However, Walmart also is a leader in a pioneering technologies to achieve operational efficiencies that ultimately bring savings for its customers. One such technology is RFID, which transfers data stored on tags on a product or other object, facilitating identification and tracking. One use of RFID technology familiar to many people is in vehicle transponders for toll collections. Walmart has been using RFID technology for about a decade and cites numerous benefits, including more efficient inventory management. The company initially introduced RFID to track pallets of merchandise traveling along its supply chain, including at warehouses. In 2007, executives credited the technology with, among other things, cutting the volume of excess inventory in Walmart's massive supply chain and slashing out of stock occurrences by almost one-third. In 2010, the retailer announced the next phase of its RFID strategy, placing tags on individual garments. Let's look at this video, how Walmart is thinking about future. There are ample of opportunities for this technology and retail to go hand in hand. And finally, let's see how we will shop in the coming few years. I hope these contents will benefit you for taking your subject in further studies. Thank you.